Tonight, the ONE Welterweight World Championship is on the line. Zebaztian Kadestam is determined to remain the king of the division as the Swedish knockout artist defends his belt for the first time. Threatening his legacy is a hungry, dangerous Kazakh, Georgiy Kichigin. The submission ace has plans of his own to claim the welterweight world title. It's an epic striker versus grappler showdown. Reign of Valor, live from Yangon, Myanmar, starts now. Watching the best of ONE Championship. ONE Championship returned to Yangon, Myanmar with ONE Reign of Valor. Swedish knockout artist Zebaztian Kadestam defends his ONE Welterweight World title against submission wizard Georgiy Kichigin. We join this World Championship bout in round two.
Second round of five, our main event for the Welterweight Championship of the World. Defending champion Zebaztian Kadestam of Sweden in the white trunks. The challenger Georgiy Kichigin, an FNG welterweight champion in the green and black. Shoots in early, does Kichigin, stuffs the takedown attempt as Kadestam.
He's got to dig those underhooks. He's got to try to pull Kichigin up to his body, up to his waist, to get him away from the legs. Kichigin's got those long arms, so he's able to get a hand clasp and take Kadestam for a ride, when normally, you know, a shorter arm athlete is not going to be able to do that.
Tying up the legs here, Georgiy Kichigin, the man they call the Knight. 16 submissions and 20 wins. Comes in tonight on a 14-bout win streak, does Kichigin. And he keep the streak alive, but more than that, can he take the title back to Kazakhstan?
Sebastian's got to try to get one of his legs free. You can see how Kichigin has both legs tied up like that. He's got to try to get at least one leg free or pull up Kichigin so that his hands are above his waist so he can create a little bit of space and start to separate his legs. Kichigin might take the back. Kadestam's got to press his back up against the cage now so Kichigin can't secure the back position.
Zebaztian Kadestam, one of over 120 world champions on the ONE Championship roster. Kichigin has the back standing of the champ. Swings in a knee, hits that sciatic area. Tries to turn back into him, does so now Kadestam. Well done, the Swedes go for a ride. No. It was funny earlier this week, Mitch. Kichigin came up to me and said, "You'll give me boom shakalaka."
He almost did right there.
He almost had one, man.
He almost did. He wants it. I think he wants that more than he wants the title.
Single leg here from Kichigin. Causing a lot of problems so far for Zebaztian Kadestam, who has not been able to launch his striking arsenal because Kichigin has stayed glued to him for almost 1.5 rounds.
And this is wears on you. This constant defense of takedowns, it just drains you, especially when, look at how he's driving that shoulder in. He's got his hands clasped. Sebastian's doing a good job. He's trying to separate the hands. See how he has two on one control, and he still can't separate the hands. He has two of his hands against Kichigin, and he can't separate it.
Good call there from referee Kim Ching to restart them from the center of the cage. He wants to see some more action. Here's the striking now from Kadestam. Jab two from Kichigin, those long arms of the Kazakh. Jab overhand right from Kadestam. And he land the power he's renowned for. Also a Muay Thai champion, Zebaztian Kadestam. Oh, jab, smack bang on the kisser. And Kichigin does a quick count of his teeth. Kadestam got the right hand ready to go here. Just needs to find the opening. Slings the legs instead.
I'm very impressed with Zebaztian Kadestam's gas tank. We've seen in his previous matches, but the way that Kichigin is wearing on him, and he still looks fresh. He's still got a nice little pop and a little explosion to his punches. And he's got to keep going after that leg. That leg kick, that's going to be a success. That's going to pay dividends in the later rounds.
Have a look at this. Kichigin landing the gloves. The jab two was superb. Here's the high knee. The Muay Thai clinch from Georgiy Kichigin. And Kadestam gets rid of that. Kichigin drops levels. Double leg now from the Kazakh. Picks him up. Is he going to take it for a ride now?
It's hard to defend once he gets those hands clasped together. If he gets his hands tied together and they're under your butt, you're going for a ride. There's not a lot you can do.
Top position for Kichigin. You can see the damage from the leg kicks of Kadestam to that left thigh and hamstring area of Kichigin. Under a minute remains. Second round set for five. The ONE Championship welterweight world title on the line. Defending champion Zebaztian Kadestam of Sweden. The challenger in top position, Georgiy Kichigin of Kazakhstan.
Walk for finish.
And the champion get off of his back here, Dragon.
Look at the legs of Kichigin. Those leg kicks are starting to welt up the legs of Kichigin. Sebastian's got to get back up to his feet and keep attacking that leg.
Kadestam's on his feet now, the legs locked up, and a nice crossing elbow to the orbital. That'll make you give up the leg. Final 10 seconds of the round. Elbow cracks him with it. Oh, he's tagged him. He's tagged him with that elbow. A momentary slump there from Kichigin. That elbow cracked him on the jaw. It was a ripper. Two rounds down. We've got ourselves a fantastic contest.
Look at this jab by Kadestam, just splits the guard right down the pipe. But then a majority of that round was in the grappling. That was where Kichigin really excelled, is just pressing Kadestam up against the cage and really just controlling the grapple. Look at him, he's on the floor. He's trying to breathe, he's trying to get everything back together again. Very interesting second round there from both these guys. But right now, Kichigin is on the floor.
Yeah, how do you explain that, Mitch?
Did he just miss the stool? What's going on?
I think that elbow that Kadestam hit him with genuinely hurt Kichigin. There was a momentary slump from the Kazakh in his body form.
Now he's back on the stool. Kem Chang's asking if he wants to continue.
I don't think he can go on.
Is that it?
I think this one may be over. It is over.
Wow!
Zebaztian Kadestam, I believe, hit him with that elbow that really rocked Kichigin. He can't come off his stool and answer the third round. Zebaztian Kadestam retains the world title.
I told you, when Zebaztian Kadestam hits you, he makes you rethink your life choices. He will change your mind about your career path.
It may have been a volume of strikes from Kadestam late in that second round, but that one big elbow really was the exclamation mark.
Wow, Zebaztian Kadestam, he was getting out grappled in a lot of that, those first two rounds. Let's take a look at that elbow again. You called it, Michael. You said that elbow changed the tide. Watch this, boom, right over the top.
Watch the slump, see the slump? See the slump of the body there? That's it. That elbow caught him, and immediately he slumped like he was gonna go down.
Beautiful.
That took everything out of Kichigin, everything.
Wow.
I told you, folks, like Olivier Coase said to us early this week, Kadestam's one of the hardest hitters in all of ONE Championship. He showed it tonight. Stunning. Have another look. Watch this elbow. It is stunning.
Creates a little bit of space with the shrug off the shoulder.
He's gone.
And then just, wow, beautiful win for Zebaztian Kadestam.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kem Chang, put a stop to this contest after the second round for your winner by way of technical knockout and still ONE Welterweight World Champion, Zebaztian Kadestam.
A rain of gold over the cage in Yangon. Tremendous performance. Zebaztian Kadestam defends the belt successfully for the first time. He says he wants his reign to be long. Well, he's certainly off to an impressive start.
Rene Catalan took on former world champion Yoshitaka Naito in a strawweight clash that would not go the distance. The challenger, with the knockout victory, would hand Nobita the first stoppage loss of his professional mixed martial arts career.
many more can he take? His cut wide open. Boom, again with the left hand goes Catalan. Now maybe the elbow's gonna come down.
Catalan's hurt him.
Oh, Nayuto's in trouble. He is damaged goods. It's over.
The win brings Catalan's record to 6 straight victories and puts him on track for a shot at the title. In a much-anticipated heavyweight encounter, fan favorite Alain Ngalani took on former ONE World Title challenger, Italy's Mauro Cirilli. The hammer Cirilli turned in a dominant performance in Myanmar, earning the TKO via heavy knee strikes in the first round.
Smothering tactics here from Cirilli. Big knee to the top of the head, and another one. Galani's got to get out of this predicament. He can't take those patellas to the skull anymore.
Cirilli's very heavy. I like how he's controlling the posture here of Galani. He's got to move, though.
Oh, it's over.
Ong La and Sung's protege, Tia Tong, made his ONE championship debut in front of a fervent home crowd. With the legend Ong La in his corner, Tong took on Cambodia's Rin Sarath in a catchweight encounter. A 4-time Chin State wrestling champion, Tong was able to match the Khun Khmer striker on his feet in the opening round. In the second, the Dragon Leg would rely on his wrestling to dominate the clinch and secure multiple takedowns. While the Cambodian looked to use his strikes to rough up Tong at the start of the third round, Tong had an answer for every attack, going toe-to-toe with Sarath. He did enough to impress the judges, who awarded him the unanimous decision victory. After the break, Muay Thai world champion Pet Moore Kot Pet Indy Academy takes on Japanese Muay Thai champion Kenta Yamada. You're watching the Best of ONE Championship. Welcome back to the Best of ONE Championship. Fans in the Tijuana Stadium were treated to a world-class display of Muay Thai when world champion striker Pet Moore Kot Pet Indy Academy faced Kenta Yamada from Japan. We join the action in round two.
Second round of three. 3-time world Muay Thai champion Pet Moore Kot, one of over 120 martial arts world champions on our 500-plus athlete roster here at ONE Championship. Kenta Yamada, a two-division Japan national kickboxing champion, a Muay Thai world champion, competing under kickboxing rules for the first time. Pet Morakot comes forward, throws a knee to the midsection, tries to fold him in half. The 3-time Muay Thai world champion now drilling the power again. There's a beautiful front kick.
Yamada can't stay on the end of Pet Morakot's punches and kicks. He's got to get in tight. There's no elbows allowed in this kickboxing rule set. So Yamada has to take advantage of that and get close. Start going to the body again of Pet Morakot.
Yamada very, very wary of that left round kick of the 3-time Muay Thai world champion Pet Morakot. One of over 120 world champions at ONE Championship. Yamada grooving, dancing, drops his hands a little low though, chin high up in the air. Pet Morakot ties him up, can work the knees for 3 seconds. Got to be continuous. Elias Delapsis didn't like it and calls break. The kickboxing champion of Japan, Yamada. The 3-time world Muay Thai champion, Pet Morakot. Comes out jabbing, throws the cross. Step through knee from the world champion. Another knee from the world champion. And referee Delapsis breaks it.
I wonder how long it's going to take Pet Morakot to figure out that when Yamada attacks the inside leg, you can see the welt starting to build up on the inside leg there of Pet Morakot. Yamada leaves his chin up wide in the air. It's high into the air. Pet Morakot throws that straight left right down the pipe. As he's throwing that leg kick, he could put Yamada out.
The 3-time Muay Thai world champion, Mitch, showing no signs of having any troubles with the new rule set, where a lot of his weapons are gone from him. And look at that, full extension from the Muay Thai world champion. Roundhouse kick there from Yamada. Pet Morakot gets out of the way of the high flicking roundhouse. No mustard behind those punches on the inside though from the 2-time Japan national kickboxing champion. Throws an overhand right. And he's locked in the clinch of the Muay Thai world champion. He throws the knees.
Hey, second time. That clinch, yeah? Okay.
Well, you are allowed to clinch, but it's only for 3 seconds, and the knees must be continuous. Jabs there from Pet Morigot. Tried for the front kick, body shot from Yamada. Dancing here, Yamada. But he really hasn't put too many heavy salvos on the three-time world Muay Thai champion. Pet Morigot has beaten some greats in the past. The likes of Pet Bunchu FA Group. And there's the high kick. He throws it with no distance. That's how you do it. A three-time world Muay Thai champion. Third and final round. More than 120 martial arts world champions in one championship. And you better believe that featherweight Grand Prix that kicks off in May in Singapore is going to feature a whole heap of world champions. The best strikers on the planet will be gathered in Singapore on that night to kick off that amazing tournament. There's a reason that show's called Enter the Dragon. It really will be like the movie Enter the Dragon, where they invited all the best martial artists on the planet to compete in a super tournament. Outside leg kick there from Yamada. Now wants to go toe-to-toe, kick for kick with a three-time Muay Thai world champion. Tries to back up the world champion. Pet Morigot. I think he's enjoying this rule set, Mitch. Even though he's a Muay Thai world champion, he's enjoying the kickboxing.
Yeah, but Yamada's putting it on him. Yamada's found another gear in this third round. He realizes that he might be behind 2-0, and he's got to turn it on right now because this is an opportunity to take out a distinguished Muay Thai world champion and really make a name for himself. Ooh, nice little body shot landed by Pet Morigot.
This would be the biggest victory of Yamada's career. Not for the winner's medal, not for the place in the Grand Prix, which is huge, but the fact that he can say for the rest of his career he beat a three-time Muay Thai world champion on the biggest stage of all. Body shot there from Yamada, but Mitch, he lacks a bit of starch in those punches. He's got to torque a little more, got to put the hips into those punches, drive more power into the body of the triple Muay Thai world champion.
He's trying, but it's the range of Pet Morigot that's preventing him from doing that. He can't quite deliver the same power that he's known for, is because of Pet Morigot is picking him apart. He's always got a glove in his face. He's always putting him back. He's trying to push kick back. It's constant pressure coming from Pet Morigot.
We've already seen Enrico Cal, multi-world champion, advance to that tournament in Singapore, courtesy of beating Liam Nolan earlier on. He knocked out Nolan with a body shot. Will Pet Morigot, a three-time Muay Thai world champion, join Enrico Kell in Singapore in May? Will he join Petrosian and Nutterwhite and Yodson Clyde, all world champions? Uppercut on the inside, nice one, but again, lacked the power from Yamada. So too that left hook. He is catching Pet Morigot cleanly, which concerns me, Mitch, because any other power striker, Pet Morigot would be in trouble getting tagged this much. Roundhouse kick from Pet Morigot, the triple Muay Thai world champion. Glances towards his corner, all sorts of instructions from Team Pet Indy Academy. You might be wondering, is that actually his name, Pet Indy Academy? No. Thai fighters adopt the gym name as their last name. Hence you hear Yodson Clyde Fairtex. You hear Pet Dan Pet Indy Academy, and here we've got Pet Morigot Pet Indy Academy. CH is silence, by the way. That's why it's not Pet Morigot, it's Pet Morigot, Pet Indy Academy. The triple Muay Thai world champion, certainly oozing with confidence.
Here's some work put in by Yamada, landing a flurry of punches. When he gets on the inside, he is able to disrupt the rhythm of Pet Morigot. When he starts throwing those body shots, landing and making it dirty, getting in tight, he does his best work. But again, when he throws that inside leg kick, his chin is wide in the air. It's like lifted high. And Pet Morigot there on that last replay was able to fire a left right down the center.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the blue corner, head for a card, NLT Academy.
Pat Morakot books a place in the ONE Super Series Featherweight World Grand Prix, which kicks off in May. Also punching his ticket to the ONE Super Series Featherweight World Grand Prix, debutant Enrico the Hurricane Kell. In an explosive outing against England's Liam Nolan, he earned the TKO in the second round.
Enrico Kell, a man on a demolition mission. There's a second knockdown from Kell. Nolan in a whole lot of bother. He's got no answers for the brilliance of Enrico Kell. It's over. Enrico Kell scores a phenomenal ONE Super Series win on debut.
Kui Botello was in ONE Super Series kickboxing action against Japan's Yuta Watanabe. The Portuguese striker needed some time to figure out how to break through Watanabe's defense. Botello turned up the heat in the final round to overwhelm his Japanese opponent and secure the favor of the judges for the unanimous decision victory. In another Super Series kickboxing flyweight encounter, Japan's Momotaro would overwhelm Aussie Kenny C to secure the unanimous decision victory inside Tawana Indoor Stadium. In a colossal ONE Super Series light heavyweight tussle, two-time Super Combat World Champion Tariq Kababes took on Romania's Mr. KO, Andre Stoica. The tank quickly found his range to work his trademark hooks and uppercuts. The Romanian's timing was on point when he sent an off-balance Kababes tumbling to the canvas after a low kick. It was the final round that decided it for Kababes, dominating the final 3 minutes to earn the unanimous decision victory. When we return, local hero Pu Ta secures a thrilling win that sends the crowd wild. You're watching the Best of ONE Championship. Welcome back to the Best of ONE Championship. Tawana Indoor Stadium was brought to life when Pu Ta entered the cage against Indonesia's Johan Mulia Legowo for a flyweight bout. There were some nervy moments for Bushido in the thrilling encounter as Legowo escaped a guillotine attempt, working his way free and taking Pu Ta's back. Pu Ta would survive the scare to secure the victory by strikes.
Potal's long limbs are raining down the punches again. Final seconds of the opening round. Legowo in trouble. Legowo in trouble. Legowo may be gone. It's goodnight, Irene!
It would be a night for the new stars of Myanmar. Home hope Bozina Antoniar entered the cage against Malaysia's Audrey Laura Boniface in an atomweight bout. Toto confidently walked out with national hero Ong Lan Sung. And in thrilling fashion, she would secure the knockout in the second round.
To save herself is to take it to ground, but not like this. Here's Boniface in trouble. Here's Antoniar exploding. There's the victory. Here's the meltdown.
China's Lin Hechun had a debut to remember in her atomweight clash, becoming the first person to finish Philippines' Jomari Torres by submission in the last minute of the first round.
Oh, there it is. The triangle is on for Lin Hechun. Jomari Torres could be in trouble.
She's in a bad spot. That triangle with those long legs of Lin Hechun is just gonna get tighter and tighter. Yep, that's it.
Lin Hechun gets the victory.
Chinese compatriot Chen Rui was in action in a bantamweight clash. He shuts down Roman Alvarez with a series of uppercuts for a TKO victory in the second round.
Oh, body shots hurt him, pulled him in half, this one's over.
Wow, beautifully timed shot from Chen Rui.
India's number one pound-for-pound mixed martial artist, Gurdarshan Mangat, made his debut in Myanmar. Taking on Finland's Tony Taru, St. Lion held nothing back and would earn the TKO victory in the third round.
Gurdarshan Mangat, the confidence flowing now. He's done the damage to Taru. Taru locks onto a leg. Hammer fist strikes, it's all over. Gurdarshan Mangat wins on debut.